What is SRE? SRE stands for Site or Systems Reliability Engineering and is a discipline that focuses on improving the reliability and performance of software systems. It combines principles from software engineering and system administration to ensure that software systems are available and functioning at all times. In this video, we will explore what SRE is, look at the core principles behind it, and we will also discuss some of the tools and skills needed to support SRE efforts. SRE is a discipline that emphasizes reliability in software systems. For the average developing team, the main priority is placed on creating new features as quickly as possible and shipping them out. Yes, scalability and reliability are somewhere on the list of priorities, but to be completely honest, it's not the top priority. Deadlines and Jira tickets take precedence. This is where operations comes in. Operation teams are focused on reliability and ensuring the long life of the code. SRE and DevOps are both roles that sprung forth from the need to connect these two mindsets. This is achieved through a combination of proactive monitoring and maintenance, automation, and a culture of continuous improvement. SRE teams focus on minimizing downtime and maximizing the availability of software systems, which helps reduce costs and improve user satisfaction. So what is the difference between SRE and DevOps? While SRE and DevOps share many similarities, they are not the same thing. DevOps is a very broad term, and the classical definition technically is a cultural movement that emphasizes collaboration between the development and operations teams. In this sense, we should all be DevOps. But we don't live in a perfect world, so most companies hire a guy or gal to be the DevOps person. While DevOps engineers should have SRE as their top priority, many engineers are typically more focused on deployment. Their number one priority is to automate processes for CI/CD. Many DevOps engineers get too caught up in metrics like deployment frequency, lead time, mean time to recovery, and change failure rate. Feel free to disagree with me down in the comments below. SRE, on the other hand, is a laser-focused approach to software engineering with its sights set on reliability. There is a ton of overlap between SRE and DevOps. In smaller teams, you might be doing, well, pretty much all of this. Shout out to all the entrepreneurs out there. But in the theoretical realm, DevOps is a broader concept that encompasses a wide range of practices aimed at improving the speed and efficiency of software delivery, while SRE is a more focused approach that prioritizes reliability over speed. Principles for SRE. So what are some principles of SRE? They include emphasizing availability over functionality. SRE teams prioritize the availability of software systems over their functionality. This means that SRE teams will prioritize fixing problems that affect availability over adding new features. SRE focuses on minimizing downtime and maximizing reliability through proactive identification and resolution of potential problems. Automating manual processes. SRE teams are responsible for automating manual processes such as alerts, fail-safes, and problem resolution. They are also responsible for implementing proactive monitoring. SRE teams use a range of monitoring and maintenance tools to proactively identify and resolve potential problems before they become major issues. Monitoring tools are absolutely necessary for any SRE team. SRE teams need tools that provide a comprehensive view of the entire system, providing excellent alerting and integrating with all the different tech stacks that your team may be using. To get the full all-in-one package, try out Semitex, a full-stack monitoring tool. Link to a freemium version down below. So how do you get started with SRE? SRE can be a little bit overwhelming and is not really a job for junior developers. But with the right resources and a solid plan, anybody can learn the basics and be well on their way to becoming an SRE professional. Here are some steps to take to get you started. Familiarize yourself with the basics. Start by reading the Google SRE book, which provides an overview of SRE philosophy and practices. Google technically started SRE, so yeah, learn from the source. You can also check out resources online such as blogs and forums, as well as attend SRE-related events and webinars. Learn more about the tools and technologies used in SRE. Familiarizing yourself with the tools and technologies used in the SRE field will help you get a better understanding of the discipline itself. You should look into monitoring tools such as Semitex, Prometheus, or Grafana, as well as automation tools such as Ansible, Chef, and Puppet. You should also build a strong foundation in system administration. SRE is a combination of software engineering and system administration, so having a strong foundation in system administration is critical. There are plenty of good resources online, like you can take online courses for free, attend workshops, or read books to build your skills in this area. And finally, and probably the most important, is to get some hands-on experience with SRE. The best way to learn SRE is by doing, If you are already a developer, you can start by volunteering to work on your SRE projects in your organization, or start a personal project where you can experiment with different SRE techniques and tools. Getting started with SRE requires a combination of learning and hands-on experience. Start by familiarizing yourself with the basics, learning about the tools and techniques used in SRE, building a strong foundation in system administration, and getting hands-on experience. With persistence and dedication, anyone can become an SRE professional. Check out semitex.com for lots of reading materials and for a free trial to our monitoring tool. Link for all of that down in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Keep monitoring, everybody.